Now, having dealt the game, the way we're going to play this follow suit game is I was a dealer in this particular case. And we can tell because I have the pot still here. So, with follow suit, or in Euchre too, the person to the left of the dealer starts off play. And so, what this person does is they lead a card. And the object of this game is to take what we call five tricks. You have five cards, so we're all going to play one card. That's going to make up one trick. So, with the follow suit, what we do is they're going to lay a card down, and the cards are arranged by highest to lowest, being ace is highest and nine being lowest. So the object is to have the highest card. So in this case, the person played ace of diamonds. So with follow suit, the thing is that this person right here, in this case, it'd be you have to follow suit. So because you have a queen of diamonds, you have to play the queen of diamonds. If you don't play the queen of diamonds, it's called reneging if you get caught, which you shouldn't do. So, but you have to follow suit. Here with this person over here, let's look at their cards. In this particular case, they don't have any diamonds. So because they don't have any diamonds, we have some hearts, spades, and a club, and another heart over here. A lot of times we like to arrange our cards together like that. But because this person does not have any diamonds, this person right here can throw up any card that they want to. So. But the card means nothing. So, like here, an ace is a high card. They don't want to throw off an ace card. What they would rather do is throw off a card that's pretty worthless, like a nine. So this card, though, is worthless. So even if the card was higher in value than the rest of the cards, it is still worthless. Of course, this is not a big deal because keep in mind the people that are across from each other are partners. So in this case, this person's partner is already winning the trick. And then finally, it's my turn to go. And I don't have because ace is the highest, I can't do anything to beat it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw off a low card. Don't throw off my jack because it's higher. I'm going to throw off a nice low card because it's throwing away the card. So in this particular hand, typically we don't show the cards, but I want to show the cards so that you can follow along pretty nicely. So in this particular hand, the person to my left actually won the trick because they have the highest card. They gather up the cards. Set them off to the side. And then because they won, they get to lead. So let's look at this person's cards here. And so once again, the name of the game is trying to get as many tricks as you can. And we want to get at least three tricks to win. So in this particular case, the smart thing to do would be lay the high card. Even though there might be an ace out there that can beat it, but still, we want to give it a chance. Because keep in mind, there's four cards out here that are buried, we call buried in the pot. And then we also have a partner that also might have the high card too. So we're going to try leading with the high card. A very common mistake with new players is for some reason they're afraid of losing this high card and they play this card right here. And it's like, well, why would you play to lose? So when you play, if you're a new person, you can't go wrong with playing your high card. So here, put that king down. You would have to follow suit, of course, which is to your advantage in this case, anyways, because it's the higher card. And then we go to the next player. This player only has one club, has to follow suit. So at this point, it's kind of brainless what to do. Here, I have a slight decision because I have two cards, a queen and a 10. Of course, my partner is already winning the hand, and this queen is worthless anyways by itself. So why not get rid of my low card? And that's what I would do. So in this particular case, you, the person in the camera, has actually taken that particular trick. You put the cards by you. And now it's your turn to lead. Once again, you can't really go wrong by playing your highest card. So here, we play the highest card, which is ace spades. First to the left has to follow suit. I don't have any spades, so now I'm just basically throwing away a card. And of course, the best thing, if you're going to throw away a card, you might as well throw away your lowest card. And then finally, the last person, they have one spade, so they don't have too much choice. Now you, the person in the camera, has a second trick. Keep in mind, there's five tricks here. So what we need to do is to get one point, we need to at least take three tricks. So going back to our last hand here, this kind of brings up something kind of interesting. Because you have two cards left. You have a queen of spades and a ten of hearts. Which one do you play? Of course, a lot of times, I always told you can't go wrong with the highest card. But in this case, you kind of still want to go with that particular card because you already took three spades out. So the chances are everyone else probably doesn't have another spade. That makes sense? Keep in mind, there's only about like six cards of each suit. So you already took three of them. You have four. There's only two more spades out there. Yeah, the king might be there, but the king might be there, but it's a good chance. It's good risk to take. Otherwise, you're playing this low card here, which everyone has hearts, so the chances are very good that someone has a higher card than this. So let's go ahead and play this queen of spades. And of course, this person doesn't have a spade, so they're gonna throw away their lower card. I don't have a spade, so I'm gonna throw away a low card too. And then the person to my left is also going to throw away a card. So at this point, we just won another trick. So at this point, we already have 1 point. So we made 1 point. If we were to keep on playing, it doesn't matter at this point, but if we were to take, my team was to take all five tricks, if we get all five tricks, then my team will get 2 points. And in this case, it doesn't really matter because the other team took one, so we're just basically throwing our cards. And there's a lot of times in Euchre where people just throw in their cards. And the reason why they do that is because it's already been decided what the points are.